بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear students, now we discuss mucopolysaccharides and proteoglycans. Key concepts include mucopolysaccharides, glycosaminoglycans, classification of glycosaminoglycans, functions of glycosaminoglycans, proteoglycans, examples of proteoglycans, and functions of proteoglycans. Mucopolysaccharides. The most abundant heteropolysaccharides in the body are glycosaminoglycans, which are abbreviated as GAG. The glycosaminoglycans are historically referred to as the mucopolysaccharides, given that they were originally characterized in mucous membranes and mucosal exudates. The glycosaminoglycans molecules are long, linear, unbranched polysaccharides containing a repeating disaccharide unit. Mucopolysaccharides are a special type of polysaccharides that typically consist of long repeating disaccharide units which have been modified to contain an amino sugar and a uronic acid. It has some sort of negatively charged groups, a large complex of negatively charges such as carboxy and sulfate groups, heteropolysaccharide chains generally associated with small amount of protein, that is proteoglycans. Mucopolysaccharides. The disaccharide unit contain either of two modified amino sugars such as N-acetylgalactosamine or N-acetylglucosamine and a uronic acid such as glucuronic acid and iodoronic acid. Glycosaminoglycans are highly negatively charged molecules. Glycosaminoglycans impart high viscosity to the solution in which they reside. Glycosaminoglycans are located primarily on the surface of cells or in the extracellular matrix, but are also found in secretory vesicles in some types of cells. Special ability to bind large amount of water producing gel-like matrix that forms the body's ground substance. Glycosaminoglycans, along with the high viscosity of glycosaminoglycans, comes low compressibility, which makes these molecules ideal for a lubricating fluid in the joints. Their rigidity provides structural integrity to cells and provides passageways between cells, allowing for cell migration. Now the classification of glycosaminoglycans. Two types, one is sulfate containing and second is sulfate free. Sulfate containing consists of chondroitin sulfate, dermatan sulfate, keratin sulfate, heparin and heparan sulfate, whereas sulfate free is hyaluronic acid. Chondroitin sulfate. Chondroitin sulfate contains D-glucuronic acid and galactosamine, as you see in the structure. It is the most abundant glycosaminoglycans in the body. It is widely distributed in the bone, heart, cartilage, extra. Here is the structure of chondroitin sulfate. D-glucuronic acids combined with the N-acetyl D-galactosamine to produce chondroitin sulfate. In this structure, carboxylate ion group and sulfate ion group are also present in the glucose. Again, you can see the structure of chondroitin sulfate. Chondroitin sulfates are sulfated glycosaminoglycans with alternating chain of N-acetide galactosamine and glucuronic acid. Chondroitin sulfate had a similar structure to hyaluronic acid. Functions of chondroitin sulfate. Chondroitin sulfate is very much important in the functions of cartilage due to electrostatic repulsive forces generating from sulfate groups in chondroitin sulfate. Cartilage has high compression resistance compared to other tissue types. Chondroitin sulfate has both structure and regulatory functions, which depend on the properties of proteoglycans of which it is a part. It is a main component of native extracellular matrix and plays a key role in maintaining the structural integrity of tissues. Gradual loss of chondroitin sulfate from cartilage is a major cause of osteoarthritis. Chondroitin sulfate is involved in cell signaling and recognition of extracellular matrix to cell surfaces and has anti-inflammatory properties to give more stimulation for chondrogenesis. Classification of chondroitin sulfate. Chondroitin sulfate classification based on the site of sulfation. Chondroitin sulfate is classified into four components as chondroitin 4 sulfate, chondroitin 6 sulfate, chondroitin 2,6 sulfate, and chondroitin 4,6 sulfate. Hyaluronic acid. Hyaluronic acid consists of D-glucuronic acid and glucosamine, as you see in the structure. It is a sulfate-free glycosaminoglycans. In structure, glucuronic acid can be made from glucose if we move hydrogen from number 6 carbon position. Glucuronic acid combined with N-acetyl glucosamine to produce hyaluronic acid, as you see in the structure. It is the ground substance of synovial fluid of joints, vitreous humor of eyes, connective tissues and tendon. Hyaluronidase is an enzyme that breaks beta-1-4 linkages. It is present in high concentration in testes, seminal fluid, and in certain snakes and insect venom. It helps in cell migration during embryogenesis. Structure of hyaluronic acid. Hyaluronic acid is composed of equal molecules of the glucuronic acid and N-acetyl D-glucosamine, which alternate in the heteropolysaccharide. The linkages from the amino sugar to the acid are beta-1,4, and those from the acid to the amino sugar are beta-1,3, as you can see in the structure. Function of hyaluronic acid. It serves as a lubricant and a sharp absorbent in joints. It determines charge selectiveness of renal glomerulus. It acts as sieve in extracellular matrix. It permits cell migration during morphogenesis and wound repair. Hyaluronidase enzyme of semen degrades the gel around ovum and allows effective penetration of sperm into ovum. Dermatan sulfate. Dermatan sulfate contains L-hyaluronic acid and glucosamine. As you can see in the structure, L-hyaluronic acid reacts with N-acetylgalactosamine 4 sulfate to produce dermatan sulfate. Functions of dermatan sulfate. It holds LDL molecules and participates in atherosclerosis. Dermatan sulfate is found in the cornea and sclera of the eye, which helps to maintain corneal transparency and shape of the eye. Many other tissues in animals and humans also contain dermatan, such as blood vessel wall, heart valve, and umbilical cord. Dermatan sulfates may occur at the carbon number 4 or carbon number 6 positions of L-hydronic acid. They are found to increase normally with age, except in disease conditions. Present in sclera of eye, where it has important function in maintaining overall shape of eye. It may function in coagulation, wound repair, fibrosis, and infection. Excess accumulation in the mitral wall can result in mitral wall prolapse. Here again you can see the structure of dermatan sulfate, in which L-hydronate combines with N-acetyl D-galactosamine 4 sulfates to produce dermatan sulfate. Heparin contains D-glucuronic acid with glycosamine. It is the only intracellular glycose aminoglycan. Here you can see the structure of heparin. D-glucuronate 2 sulfate combined with N-sulfoglucosamine 6 sulfate to produce heparin. First sugar contains carboxylate anion, which bears the negative charge, and sulfate ion also bears the negative charge. Second sugar of this disaccharide sulfate group, which also have negative charge. These negative charges give the heparin its functionality. Heparin is mainly stored intracellularly in the granules of the mast cell, which are the immune cells. Released by mast cells at site of injury and infection, it may be released in response to a specific stimulus. The main uronic acid of heparin is the 1-L-hydrouronic acid. Although D-glucuronic acid is also present, heparin is a well-known anticoagulant that prevents blood clotting, that binds to factors 9 and factor 11, but most importantly it interacts with plasma and antithrombin 3. Functions of heparin: it helps to clear lipidemia after fatty meal, also called clearing factor. Clinically useful as an injectable anticoagulant, although the precise role in vivo is likely defense against invading bacteria and foreign substances. Found in granules of mast cell that line the arteries of lung, liver, kidney, and spleen. It is strongly acidic due to presence of more sulfate group. Heparin helps in the release of the enzyme lipoprotein lipase. Heparin sulfate has same as heparin, except some amino groups carry acetyl group and percent of sulfate groups are smaller. It is extracellular glycose aminoglycase. Its structure is similar to heparin. Functions of heparin sulfate: it is present in basement membrane and as a ubiquitous component of cell surface. Derived from endothelial cells and acts as anticoagulant molecules. They participate in cell growth and communication. Keratin sulfate: in keratin sulfate, the disaccharide unit composed of D-galactose with sulfate carbon number 6 with glycose amine and acetyl glycose amine with sulfate carbon number 6, as you shown in the structure. Only glycose aminoglycans with no uronic acid. Here you can see the structure of keratin sulfate. D-galactose combined with N-acetyl-D glucosamine C6-sulfate to produce keratin sulfate. Functions of keratin sulfate. Keratin sulfate found in cornea and tendon. Two types. Keratin sulfate 1 cornea, keratin 2 skeletal muscle. Maintains the corneal transparency. Usually associated with protein forming proteoglycans. Keratin sulfate proteoglycans include lomican, keratocan, fibromedulin, agrican, osteoadherin and prolegrin. Functions of glycose aminoglycans. It is the structural component of extracellular matrix. It contributes to the turnover of various tissues. Glycose aminoglycans acts as sieves in extracellular matrix. It facilitates cell migration, acts as a shock absorber at joints. Glycose aminoglycans maintenance of compressibility of cartilage. Glycose aminoglycans have a structural role in sclera and in corneal transparency. Glycose aminoglycans acts as anticoagulant. It determines the charge selectiveness of renal glomerulus, formation of cell membrane and synaptic vesicles. It is present in extracellular matrix of cartilage and plays the role of absorbing shocks. Now we discuss proteoglycans. Proteoglycans are complex extracellular macromolecules. Proteoglycans are proteins that are heavily glycosylated. The basic proteoglycan unit consists of a core protein with one or more covalently attached glycose aminoglycan strands. Glycosylation is the reaction in which a carbohydrate, which is a glycosyl donor, is attached to a hydroxyl or other functional group of another molecule, which is a glycosyl acceptor. Here you can see the structure of proteoglycans, in which protein linked covalently with the carbohydrate sugar. Proteoglycans are proteins that are attached to glycose aminoglycans. Glycoproteins that are mostly carbohydrate, which are glycans with proteins, carry attachment sites for large O-linked glycose aminoglycans. Glycose aminoglycans are the part of proteoglycans attached to protein portion as serine or threonine. Proteoglycans mostly often repeating disaccharide of amino sugar, that is N-acetyl, and uronic acid sugar with carboxylate anion. Sulfate group may be added post synthesis. Protein portion may be transmembrane or lipid linked. Sugar chain usually on extracellular side. Many hydrophilic groups highly hydrated are attached. Carbohydrate chains are negatively charged due to the presence of sulfate and uronic acid groups. Now the structure of proteoglycans. Proteoglycans consist of glycose aminoglycans with core proteins. The glycose aminoglycans chain consists of alternating hexosamine and hexuronic acid or galactose units. The glycose aminoglycans, which is abbreviated as GAG, extend perpendicularly from the core in a brush-like structure. The linkage of glycose aminoglycans to the protein core in most but not all the proteoglycans involve a specific tetrasaccharide linker to galactose residues and xylose residue, forming a structure such as GAG, GLAA, galactose, then galactose, then xylose, then serine protein as shown in the next slide. Here you can see the basic structure of proteoglycans. You will start from the left side, which is the glycose aminoglycans combined with glucuronic acid, which is abbreviated as GLCA, and also combined with the two molecules of galactose, abbreviated as GAL, and then combined with xylose, and then attached with serine protein. All these molecules combine to form the basic structure of proteoglycans. Here you can see the another way the structure of proteoglycans. Now the examples of proteoglycans. Number one, syndicans. Syndicans constitute a family of transmembrane proteoglycans that perform multiple functions during development, damage, repair, tumor growth, angiogenesis and neurogenesis. Number two, glepicans. Glepicans are heparin sulfate proteoglycans involved mainly in the regulation of growth factor signaling. Another examples of proteoglycans is the aggrecans. Aggrecans is a critical component for cartilage structure and the function of joints. Number four is the lumican. Lumican is a proteoglycan member of the SMAD leucine rich proteoglycan family, which is a major keratin sulfate proteoglycan of the cornea and is involved in collagen fibril organization, cornea transparency and tissue repair. Number fifth is the perlecan. Perlecan is a large heparin sulfate proteoglycan, multi-domain proteoglycan that binds to and cross-links many extracellular matrix components and cell surface molecules. Now we discuss functions of proteoglycans. Proteoglycans are a major component of the animal extracellular matrix, the filler substance existing between cells in an organism, important in connective tissues. Proteoglycans act like sponge. Water squeezes out under mechanical pressure quickly, springs back to original shape when pressure relieved. A kind of shock absorber by proteoglycans. Briefly discuss the functions of proteoglycans. It provides structural support to prevent cell rupture, as joint lubricants used, as structural components of tissue, that is the connective tissue, to bind cells to the extracellular matrix, to regulate movements of molecules through the matrix. Functions of proteoglycans. All cellular processes involve interactions at the cell surface of the cell, including the interactions of the cell wall with the matrix, with other cells, as well as with the ligands. These interactions involve proteoglycans. Syndicans, which is an example of proteoglycan, are transmembrane proteins that are linked to the cell membrane. Now we discuss mucopolysaccharidosis. Mucopolysaccharides are hereditary progressive disease caused by mutations of genes coding for lysosomal enzymes, leading to defects in stepwise breakdown of glycosaminoglycans. Glycosaminoglycans, formerly named as mucopolysaccharides, are large complex polymers of linear repeating sulfated acidic and amino sugar disaccharide units widely distributed in most of the tissues. Now, what are lysosomes? Cell organelles that is present in the cell. Lysosomes contain hydrolytic enzymes which helps in breakdown and use of fats and cholesterol in the body. In other words, lysosomes helps in the digestion of a cell. These are also known as the suicidal bats. Lysosome disease is a condition that affects many parts of the body. This disorder, lipase deficiency, is an inherited disaccumulation of lipids leads to several health problems including an enlarged liver and spleen. Lysosomal storage disease. Lysosomal storage disease is a group of disorders that affects specific enzymes. Lysosomal storage accumulation usually caused by the lysosomal dysfunction, usually deficiency of single enzyme required for metabolism of lipids, for example mucopolysaccharides and glycoproteins, etc. Lysosomal storage diseases are more than 50 types, if it may classify. The precise mechanisms underlying this degeneration are incompletely defined. Now, classification. Classification involves mucopolysaccharidosis, that is variable nervous system involvement, mucolipidosis, glycoproteinosis, and glycogen storage, etc. Mucopolysaccharidosis, long unbranched polysaccharides consisting of a repeating disaccharide unit. Mucopolysaccharidosis are a hereditary disorder. This disease caused by mutations of genes coding for lysosomal enzymes. This is needed to degrade glycose aminoglycans that are GAG acid mucopolysaccharides, long chain complex carbohydrate. They are components of the ground substance of bone and cartilage, lubricant in joint fluid, and the surface coating that initially binds growth factors to cells. Mucopolysaccharidosis, the metabolic recycling of glycose aminoglycans requires the stepwise degradation of the terminal sulfate, acidic and amino sugar residues by a series of lysosomal enzymes. The deficiency of one of these enzymes blocks degradation of the substrate and results in a specific disorder. The mucopolysaccharides share many clinical features but have varying degrees of severity depending on the mucopolysaccharidosis subtype. These features may not be apparent at birth but progress as storage of glycose aminoglycans increases with time, affecting bone, skeletal structure, connective tissues, brain and internal organs. Hurler syndrome. Mucopolysaccharidosis type 1, also called Hurler syndrome, an inherited metabolic disorder caused by an enzyme alpha L-iodouronidase. The alpha L-iodouronidase gene are mutation
This enzyme main property in breakdown long chains of sugar molecules called glycose aminoglycans. As a result, these molecules accumulate in the body, causing numerous health problems. If untreated, children with mucopolysaccharidosis type 1 usually die before the age of 10. Approximately 1 in 1 million individuals are affected with Hurler syndrome worldwide. The mother and father are both found to be mucopolysaccharidosis type 1 carriers. What is Hunter disease? This is also known as Hunter syndrome. Glycose aminoglycans builds up in cells throughout the body. Due to a deficiency or absence of the enzyme iduronate 2-sulfate, the breakdown of dermatan sulfate requires the lysosomal enzyme iduronate 2-sulfate, abbreviated as IDS. The iduronate 2-sulfate gene are mutation in the Hunter disease. The incidence pattern among males of approximately 1 in 1.3 million males live births. As for inheritance pattern, the mother less in carrier and father are more in found to iduronate 2-sulfate carrier. Now the symptoms of all these diseases. The features of the diseases may not be apparent at birth, but progress as storage of glycose aminoglycans increases with the time, affecting bone, skeletal structure, connective tissues, brain, and internal organs. By 1 year of age, signs and symptoms of the disorder become apparent. Affected systems include skeletal, neurologic, cardiovascular, hearing, digestive, vision, and respiratory. Symptoms can be severe, including joint deformities, deafness, blindness, and significant developmental regression. Other symptoms include mental retardation, development delay, severe behavioral problems, corneal clouding, coarse facial features, short trunk, skeletal irregularities, hernias, joint stiffness, hydrocephalus, cardiac disease, retinal degeneration, and hair loss.
Thank you very much.